So she decides to take kind of what she called, you know, her one last flight. But she chooses one of the hardest things she could possibly do, which is to fly around the world along the equator. Amelia Earhart is the most recognized woman in aviation. Amelia always had different ideas about who she wanted to be. She always thought that she would do something different. She wasn't particularly interested in marriage and having children or being a school teacher. So she considered many different things and eventually decided to become a pilot. And immediately after earning her license, she decided to set an altitude record. Beyond that, then, you know, she got noticed to be the first woman to be a passenger to fly across the Atlantic Ocean, going with two male pilots. But she had been told that she would get time at the controls so that she would be able to fly the plane too. Over the course of the flight, though, however, she never did get the opportunity to fly the aircraft. And she was deeply disappointed and actually said that she felt like I was a sack of potatoes. Then she determined that she needed to prove herself. And so she decided that she wanted to do a solo flight across the Atlantic, doing it in 1932. The museum is very honored to have Amelia Earhart's Lockheed Vega, the one in which she became the first woman to solo the Atlantic Ocean. And it's just a fantastic airplane. You know, it's one of the planes of the era that just has the look of a new exciting technology. And this one in particular had really wonderful streamlined design to it, which made it very speedy and just looked terrific. Amelia was very interested in having women become part of aviation because they were a necessary part. There was no reason why women shouldn't be involved. They deserve to have a choice to enter this new field back in the 20s and 30s just as much as any men. It's the time frame when not everybody agrees with that, so she's willing to push the boundaries to do that. Amelia had set so many records already, and you know, she was contemplating, you know, how long is she going to fly? How long is she going to continue to do that? Because she's been contributing in many other ways to aviation too. So she decides to take kind of what she called, you know, her one last flight. But she chooses one of the hardest things she could possibly do, which is to fly around the world along the equator, flying their Lockheed Electra. It was a beautiful plane. They had everything they needed in most regards. And in the end, unfortunately, she was unable to make that flight. She was lost. She and her navigator, Fred Noonan, became lost on the leg between Ley, New Guinea to Howland Island. That set off the largest search for anyone in the Pacific Ocean for decades to come.
Let us know what your favorite part of this video was in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. Also, you can follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and be sure to subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.